Good afternoon, good afternoon. Julie put me on the spot. But everybody that know me know one thing, I love to rub my mouth. So why not rub my mouth in this great time? First, let's start out with the brothers in rhyme. I remember going to, I'm gonna forget what year it was. I know it was the early 90s. It had to be like 93. I'm originally from Louisiana. I first moved to Houston. And what I moved to was a neighborhood called Crestmont Park. So when I went out there, that's when I first met with the Biden boys. They was all out there with the slabs. We hadn't seen that. So there was a guy that everybody was talking about. You need to hear rap. So the guy was Fat Pat. And it was something about Fat Pat. Big tall adult guy. I don't think he ever had a dog girl, but he looked like Fat Pat. That's what it is. So like the whole lingo. There may be other people that create the things, but the lingo of the screwed up clique in Southside of Houston had to come from Fat Pat. Because I don't care what it was, he made it sound good. Man, you got to eat the taco like this, baby. He just was. And you know, no one was ready for what, you know, the world was about to see. And I remember when we first went to the studio, he didn't even write raps at the time. He was freestyling. But those were like the beginning, my early memories of meeting him. And next Big Hawk, which was his brother. So Hawk was working at American Gym at the time that I remember. And I used to be telling Hawk, like, say, we can rap and make a career out of this. So Hawk used to be like, man, I just do it the fuck. I ain't good at it, you know what I'm saying? So to me, those are the big brothers of S.U.C. Now, let's not get wrong, Wood is in here. When I first went to Screwhouse, Body Boys the one took me to Screwhouse first. I hope y'all recorded a lot of this so people can see this history. But, and I remember Wood and Grace, their early days. I remember Ronnie Spencer, who might have had a long Jerry curl. There's so many people that are S.U.C. and Screwed Up Clique that was part of Screw at the beginning that never get recognized because they are not rappers, you know what I'm saying? And it's hurtful sometimes that, you know, people feel left out because this legacy is so big and so great, you know what I'm saying? So I hope, you know, everyone can accept my apology if I ever left you out, because there's so many of us, you know. And what's a great thing, I remember a few years ago, S.U.C., the reason we weren't as commercial as a lot of the other artists were, because we was real, like, I don't want to say street people, street dudes, but that's what a lot of S.U.C. was known as. Like, we was really deeply rooted in the community. So, man, the MTVs and the BTs would come to Houston, S.U.C. members and people like Screw didn't want to talk to those kind of people. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of how it was when we first met Julie. So, you know, they're like, who is this lady going out? Lady calling me. Come meet me here. She's like, yo, you're the police. So, you know, and so I don't know how long I've been on Julie, but so Screw was just like he did with S.U.C., he kicked the doors in, and you were late. And so every year, she breaks her neck and goes through something to try to get us all together. And what a great way to get us all together than in front of his own siblings to commemorate and show an exhibit honoring Big Hawk and Fat Pat, who both, you know, Fat Pat didn't get to see his ass come out. Shout out to d-reck, Red Shot Records. They played a great part in Fat Pat career and my career and everybody else here. So one of the greatest feelings I get is when I hear new artists come out, right? And the first thing they think of saying is like, we are the news. And they try to get away and go around Screw Up Clique. And for some reason, God always steps back down and say, you are not Houston without this culture. So shout out to the Travis Scotts and the Drake that are keeping our culture going.